Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
So you might already know that the concept of clickers is probably the most well-proven research outcome that came out of educational technology research. Because every time you say, here is a field, they're doing this, what is the outcome, what is the use, it turns out that the concept of clickers, okay? I have experienced many times, after a month goes in a semester, find that students haven't understood. It's a mid-semester exam, and then you think that the students should have understood something, then you haven't understood, they haven't understood. So what should you do? You go back and repeat whatever material you taught before, or would you build on that? If you say that you want to go back and repeat that, then what about the portion that you have to cover afterwards? Okay? So it makes sense to know then and there instead of waiting for a month. Okay, that's a long time. It's better to find out then and there whether students have understood what you are saying or not. Because the students have the tendency to nod their head. Whenever you say something, they will nod. It doesn't mean that they have understood. You think that they have understood, but they haven't understood. It is their natural response, okay? So that creates problems. Even simplest thing, you just say 1 + 2 = 3, then you say that, you erase it and say, what did I say now? They will not be able to, because they haven't listened to you. They were looking at your mind is somewhere else, you know, stuff like that. So it is extremely important to, I have found that the penalty for not taking care of this is quite high for a teacher. So whenever I use clicker, last time I used in 2013, when I conducted the class and we also got the class recorded. Subsequently, I'm using those videos for flip method. I'll come to that later on. But in class, live response taking, clicker is very good. It is called clicker because you might have seen in Kaun Banega Crorepati, where Amitabh Bachchan, you know, asks for quiz answers and you are supposed to click. So that is why that name clicker came. You click something, clicker. Now, this one, what I'm going to do is paper-based, possibly as a result, it is called clicker, okay? P with the, clicker with a P, right? When I use clicker in the class, I post a question and then ask students to give their response. If most students get it right, then it's fine. Whatever you have taught is okay, they have understood, go to the next question. If they haven't understood, supposing there is a big variation, there are four options, A, B, C, D, and there is everywhere equal number in every one of them, and only one is correct. Obviously, if people haven't understood, then you tell them, okay, listen to your neighbor, talk to your neighbor, okay? Conduct a poll, find that many people haven't got it right, so talk to your friends, okay? They talk to them, and then there is a lot of noise for a while. Then after a while, you see that noise comes down, you take that poll again. Same question. Okay, don't reveal the answer before that. And it turned out that most of the time, they got it right. Because they knew whom to ask, including those who guessed the answer. You don't know who guessed the answer. They got it right. They got the marks. But they know that they only guessed. Even they asked the people, so their learning also improves. And of course, if a lot of people get it right, then you know that they knew whom to ask, asked them, and got it right. So there is a horizontal learning also. There are people who say that often students learn more from their colleagues, okay, from their classmates, some students. So you enable that also. If after that also, many people don't understand, you get the wrong answer, which is very rare, but it happened. Then I would spend a few minutes to explain what the correct answer was and why it was correct. So this seems to be extra work, extra time to be spent, but it is well worth the effort. Well worth the effort, because otherwise next day you will repeat it, third day you will repeat it, you go on repeating it, you count all the time you might as well spend on the first day. Right? So what we are going to do now is I'm going to ask you some questions. So there is actually nothing fancy about the questions. It is just the methodology that I want to illustrate using this. So I have all the questions in clickers. And so I'm going to ask a question. All of you see that those of you who have the clicker card, those of you who don't have it, there is not much rocket science in this. You yourself can do this later. Every clicker card has a unique number. Just see that. Okay. It is possible for you to do a mapping. You can say that this number belongs to this student. Okay. So you can actually find out which student is answering which question correct. Okay. And each clicker card has four sides. On top of each side, it'll say A, B, C, D. So if your answer to my question is A, let A come first, A on the top. If C is the right one, have C on the top. Then I will scan your responses using my mobile. And whether your response has been recorded by my mobile or not will be seen on the screen. As if you see your number coming there, you can put your card down. I can scan your card again and again, nothing will happen. It'll record only once. Okay, so it's a very, very easy, low-tech kind of a thing, but it has been integrated with a mobile phone, mobile app. These are all free of cost, freely available at this time, but not open source, but free. If you go to that web page, it's called clickers.com. You can actually see that there. So you can see it on the URL. Does it say clickers.com? Yeah. If you go there, when you create a class, it'll come and ask how many students. So it has the option of 63 students or 40 students. So today I have taken 63 students because it's a bigger auditorium. I have chosen the bigger format so that the moment you say 63, it'll give 63 pages. Whereas if you say you have only 40 students, it'll give you 20 pages, each page having two things. 40 student class means smaller classroom. Everybody will be sitting closer. Here you are farther. So what we are going to do now is we are going to find what you think about these questions. Okay, are you ready with the answers? Those of you who have clicker cards, and you can show it to me. Yeah. As soon as your number comes, don't show it at an angle. If your number shows up on the screen, you can put your thing down. And you have to show it in the angle that I see from this mobile. It's all done. You're coming? Many people are coming, okay. Okay, so there you are. So everybody has answered. If it is a bigger class, of course, it'll take a little more time. I'm not sure whether quality of phone matters. I just bought I use a 10,000 rupee phone. I said that I'm looking for a phone made in India. So this is supposed to be assembled in Gurgaon. So I said, I'll just buy this. I don't know whether if you have a better quality phone, whether it'll help or not, that I don't know. Okay, now let's see the graph. So the question is, in what way the T10KT workshops have most benefited? Okay, so these are the answers. When you set a question, it is possible for you to indicate the correct answer. In this particular question, there is no correct answer, so you don't have to select it. But when you ask a question, 1 plus 2, what is the answer to 1 plus 2? Then give 3 as an option, give correct answer, 4, give wrong answer. And then it'll show how many people have got it right, how many people got it wrong, all that it'll tell. Okay? All right. Shall we go to the next question?
Sir, how do we get these images?
Sorry?
How do we produce these images?
How do you produce? I told you, you have to tell the class size. It gives a PDF file. You download it. What I did was I sent it to the printer who printed it and mounted it on this, sunboard. And then delivered it here and he charged me. And it's a one-time expense.
How much does it cost?
Which one? Free. Printing cost.
Yeah.
Printing and mounting card.
How much was it?
I don't even know. Yeah, I'm yet to pay for it. This is just A4 sheet. This is just A4 sheet. Yeah. As a matter of fact, tomorrow I'm going to conduct a class. I'm going to use the same thing. So after the thing is over, please, I want you to return, all of you return. Okay. Shall we take the next one? Because year end has come, I need to take feedback for students in my flip class. Okay, I'll come to that later. So 62 people have answered. Okay, let's go, let's get your answer to the second one. It is, now it is 62. Good. We have got one more person. Okay, good. So let's see the answer. Sorry?
It can also be a soft copy of phone also. This image, I can turn
it to. No.
Only on paper.
Only on paper. It's supposed to be low tech. There are many colleges that don't permit mobile phones inside.
No, I'm just asking if it works with soft copy.
Yeah. In that case, you don't even need plickers. I'm sure there are apps that work on mobile phones.
Work on a fixed camera.
Does it work on fixed camera? Yeah. No, it needs an app. So there is intelligence here. It may be possible. I've not explored it.
Holding mobile phone,
doesn't matter. And after all, in a class, you might not ask more than 3-4 questions in a 1-hour class. And it also turns out that when you ask a question, it's a good break. Students start smiling, they open, they remove this. Otherwise, it's a monotonous 1-hour long monologue. You stop it, it breaks the rhythm, and then everybody becomes part of it, and so on. It's actually a nice thing. Shall we take the next one? These patterns are available in plickers.com. The moment you create it, you can say that, give me the PDF file, it will give the PDF file. Take a printout, in fact send it to the printer, he will print it, mount it, he'll charge you. So this is what the card looks like. This is how the card looks like. There is a number, this number says 62. And it says C here, B here, A here, D here. So there are 63 unique patterns. And depending on the way you hold from the image and the image processing software that works, it knows whether you have selected A, B, C, or D. Is that okay? Yeah. Okay. Question is already there on the screen. You only have to select the option. Okay, you can even say reveal answer. Of course, there is no answer here. Okay? If you have given the thing as the correct answer, it will show which answer is correct. Okay? Here, I'm just taking the feedback. So there is nothing like which is correct and so on. So shall we go to the next one? What each student has given, it's all there available. It's all available. You can actually use it for, actually marking students if you want. Only thing is, then you have to prevent somebody from seeing each other. That's the only thing.
It can be used only when students are available at home, not from remote places like
Flickr. Remote places, it won't work. This is that way, it's a really low tech stuff. So this is the next question. It has already collected 40, 45. Okay, there you are. So very good, a lot of people are doing it through IIT Bombay X. Okay, so the other thing that happens is it forces everybody to answer. When you ask, it makes everybody to answer, everybody to participate, which is quite different from, you have a question?
Yeah, so I was just thinking that, you know, people will cheat normally, right? I mean, especially in schools using this. So what I would do is I would exchange cards with her and, you know, she would raise mine and then, you know, if I don't know the answer. So maybe when I'm raising the card, it should also read my face.
Yeah, we are, of course, yeah.
And that way, you know, the face and the card are mapped. Maybe, just a suggestion.
Yeah, so good point. That'll require, of course, image processing and so on. Even though there is image processing in this activity, end user doesn't have to worry about it. It just happens automatically. And so that's where we are. And let's just see the answer. I'll go to the next topic afterwards.
My question, connect your mobile phone to the laptop.
Yeah, so the way these two are connected is I go to Plickers.com over there. And I log in. So now the laptop is connected. When I install Plickers.com here, Plickers app, it asks for my password. It stores it here. So the moment I swipe on this Plickers.com, I automatically get connected. So both of them are connected to the same account.
Same account.
Okay. Same account. That's it. Yeah, you don't need, how will you connect that to internet? If you have internet, you need internet connection for that. For that, you need connection. Mobile, it is not required. No, without internet connection, how will you connect this? I mean, you have 4G or something, 3G, 4G, you need something on this. Yeah, you need that. In fact, there are some nice videos, Plickers videos, and you will see, you just say Plickr video. And some of them are really like first grade children or kindergarten children. One is sitting like this, one is, you know, whatever, they're all tiny ones. Each one is having this, showing it like this. And it is really nice because you catch them young and then tell them you must respond, take their feedback. It also tells the students, look, the teacher is concerned about my learning. So the teacher is actually doing it, forcing me to give my input. So it's a good thing for us to tell children. Yeah.
Sir, I guess this will work for such type of classroom, which is having steps. If the classroom is in one plane, then
you have to lift it up. You have to lift it up.
Even then, few answers will...
Sorry?
Because will overlap each other.
Yeah. So if you saw here, I don't know if you saw here, just
yes.
See this.
Yes, sir.
The moment somebody answers, thing comes, so they can put the thing down. So it takes a little bit of time. If you saw, for the first question, I took a lot more time to get the answer. But second and third, fourth, it became a lot faster. In fact, I didn't even have to move. I just held it like this. It collected. In fact, it reached about 50. Out of 60, it reached 50 without my having to do anything. And then I just have to look at the edges, then I've got everybody in. Okay? So it takes a little bit of effort. It's new technology, but it is low tech. Low tech because at the student end, not much is required. It's all in the mobile phone and this. Is that okay? Okay. Any other question?
Can we use the Akash tablet?
If you use Akash tablet, you don't need these cards. For me. So, yeah, it'll work.
For scanning, sir.
Yeah, it'll work.
It will work.
It'll work.
Thank you.
You can take photograph? No, it doesn't have the camera. It doesn't have, you need the camera. Huh? So, I believe Android version could be a problem. I don't know whether we have updated it for the latest Android version. And Plickers may work only on the latest version. One has to check compatibility. There was a question from here.
Sir, after the session,
yeah.
Can I get the result for a particular X student? Say, X student given the first question wrong, second question right,
so let's
and
see
so
whether,
on.
Let's see whether there is a report here. Okay, so you've got this. So here it says what it is, but there is also a score sheet, right? For example, I can find out who answered what. Here, card number one, first name, last name, I haven't assigned the name, but had you assigned the name, then that would come, okay?
Sir, over here, there are already 10 questions is done, okay? After that, Mr. X, for 10 questions answer means first question A, second question B, whatever they give, this kind of data can I get?
Yeah, there is a scorecard also. Let me see.
Yeah, scorecard.
Scorecard will work only when you have a correct answers on that particular.
Yeah.
Say
I am conduct a class test.
So there are two possibilities if you have a correct answer while assigning the question.
Yeah.
It is available. Yes, yes. But scorecard is not visible.
So there you are. See this. This is a spreadsheet I've got. Is that okay? This is what you wanted, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Yeah.
So what would be really nice is if this data could go back into my Moodle or my edX, and then you know, integration with my, so I need an API or way to export this data back, so then I can you can use it like for your flipped classroom then.
Maybe such a thing is already available. Maybe such a thing is okay. Already available.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, some
integration. One has to look for. This is, obviously getting very popular, very easy to use, and people would want to use that. Yeah. 63, maybe uniqueness. Some unique, they have difficulty in. Yeah, 63 into 4. Yeah. So if you want to do that, then you can always have two classes in parallel. Finish the first class, then you say, second class, please raise your thing. I'm going to run it. Then you can do this together by calling them more than one.